Very good morning. Warm welcome to all of you. Today, this is the seventh session of the Dr. B.V. Raman webinar series. A warm welcome to all of you. We start the program with the prayer. I request Srimati Lakshmi Prasad to start the prayer.
Shri Guru Bhyo Namaha. वक्रतुंड महाकाय कोटि सूर्य समप्रभा वक्रतुंड महाकाय कोटि सूर्य समप्रभा निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देवा निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देवा सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा गौरी नंदन गजानना गिरिजानंदन निरंजना गौरी नंदन गजानना गिरिजानंदन निरंजना पार्वती नंदन शुभानना पार्वती नंदन शुभानना 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 गौरी नंदन गजानना गिरिजानंदन निरंजना लंबोदर गंगाधर पुत्रं अंबारुह पंकेरुज नेत्रं वंदे भगवंतं गणपति वर वरदं वरदन्ते सुरवर भास्वंतं ओम 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 धिमित धिमित धिमि धिमित धिमित धिमि धिमित धिमित धिमि गजवदना जयतु जयतु जय जयतु जयतु जय जयतु जयतु जय शुभवदना गौरीनंदन गजानना गिरिजानंदन निरंजना गौरीनंदन 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 गजानना गिरिजानंदन निरंजना
थैंक यू श्रीमती लक्ष्मी प्रसाद फॉर योर वंडरफुल प्रेयर we will start the session. I take this opportunity to welcome all of you again. I welcome our honorary national president, Shri A.B. Shuklaji. He is with us today now. So warm welcome to you, sir. Very warm welcome to you.
Thank you.
We also have Shri Satish Sharma ji. Who will be the resource person of the day. Warm welcome to you, sir. I also welcome Srimati Sarita, who will be the another resource person of the day. Very warm welcome to you, madam. Now we start the session with a brief introduction of the resource person of the day. There are two resource persons, Pandit Satish Sharma ji and Madam Srimati Sarita. So I start with the Satish Sharma ji. Sri Satish Sharma ji is one of the very senior member of ICAS. Presently, he is shouldering the responsibility of honorary national vice president. He is also chief editor of astrological magazine, that is Jyotish Manthan. He is very popular among the astrological fraternity in the field of Vastu Shastra. His expertise, he has a great expertise in Vastu Shastra. So he, apart from the astrology, recognizing his valuable contribution in the field of astrology, ICAS has confirmed him with the title Jyotish Bhanu. Accordingly, in recognition of his contribution in the field of Vastu Shastra, he is also conferred with the title Vastu Bhanu. These are very rare occasions where people will have two titles in different fields of astrology. So apart from his mastery over Vastu Shastra and astrology, he is a great orator. So that is one plus point we have. Today he will speak on the topic astrology and Vastu.
गणपति का आह्वान हमने किया, माँ सरस्वती का भी हम आह्वान कर लें। मेरा जो विषय है उनके देवता वास्तु पुरुष और विश्वकर्मा का भी हम आह्वान कर लें। और मुझे वास्तु की बड़ी प्रेरणा देने वाले डॉक्टर बी वी रमन, मैं प्रार्थना करता हूँ कि जहाँ से हम हमें सुने और वो देखें कि उनके लगाए हुआ वृक्ष आज कितना बड़ा हो गया है, उनकी स्मृति में ये कार्यक्रम हो रहा है और उनके उत्तराधिकारियों ने, जस्टिस कपूर ने, फिर ए बी शुक्ला साहब ने कितना बड़ा काम कर दिखाया। मैं श्री शुक्ला जी और अन्य सभी वरिष्ठ अधिकारियों को प्रणाम करके अपनी बात शुरू करता हूँ। मैं कोई बहुत ऑर्गेनाइज लेक्चर ना देकर मैंने 7-8 छोटे छोटे पॉइंट्स चुने हैं। आई हैव सेलेक्टेड अ फ्यू पॉइंट्स विच मे बी फाउंड ब्रेन स्टॉर्मिंग एंड ए न्यू लुक टू द वास्तुशास्त्र, उस पर आगे बढ़कर हम काम कर सकते हैं। शुरू में 2-3 टॉपिक्स की चर्चा करूँगा, फिर एस्ट्रोलॉजी से जोड़ते हुए मैं अपना वक्तव्य पूरा करूँगा। तो सबसे पहले मैं एक चित्र दिखा रहा हूं जो कि ट्रेडिशनल वास्तु पुरुष का चित्र न होकर और एक यूनिक प्रेजेंटेशन है कि वास्तु पुरुष जैसे ऊपर से कहीं आ रहे हैं और उन्होंने ही हैज टेकन ए ग्रिप ऑफ द अर्थ दिस वे। The posture shown for him has been described in the ancient texts, कि उनके हाथ और पैर मुड़े हुए हैं, his head is down the earth, his waist is facing sky, आकाश, he is facing towards पाताल। This way we can display all the 10 directions. Two dimensional directions are north, northeast, east, southeast, south, southwest, and west, northwest. Remaining two directions, ki unki peeth, his waist is like a kurm prasth, like a tortoise. This way we can explain akash. उनका पेट झुका हुआ है टुवर्ड्स द सेंटर ऑफ द अर्थ। व्हेन वी विल रीड फिजिक्स, टू टर्मिनोलॉजी ऑफ द फिजिक्स, कि दो फोर्सेस, सेंट्रीपिटल फोर्सेस एंड सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्सेस, ये दो काम करते हैं हमारे आकाश और पाताल के लिए। The equilibrium of these two forces binds us with the earth. We cannot go out of earth. It's a state of equilibrium on the point of our longitude and latitude where we took birth or we live. साधारण किताबों में ये सब इस तरह से नहीं मिलेगा। हमको आकाश और पाताल को डिस्क्राइब करना है तो वास्तु पुरुष के इस स्वरूप को समझना होगा। शास्त्रों में इसका इशारा है पर नई पीढ़ी को समझने की बहुत ज्यादा जरूरत है। जब हम किसी भी मकान का भूमि पूजन करते हैं, आजकल उसको लेंगे फाउंडेशन स्टोन कहेंगे, भूमि पूजन कहेंगे, इष्टिका स्थापन कहेंगे, पाया स्थापन कहेंगे, पर सैकड़ों साल पहले जो टर्मिनोलॉजी चलती थी वो थी कूर्मशिला स्थापन। कूर्मशिला स्थापन वॉज ए प्रिजम्पशन व्हेन द वाटर लेवल्स आर क्वाइट नॉर्मल, 10-15 फुट नीचे पानी मिल जाता था, एंड द एंशिएंट सेजेस बिलीव्ड दैट द लेइंग ऑफ फाउंडेशन स्टोन मस्ट रीच टू द लेवल ऑफ द नॉट एग्जैक्टली वाटर, ए लिटिल अपर टू द वाटर लेवल, जहाँ नरमी हो वहाँ कूर्मशिला स्थापना हो, यानी 8-10 फुट नीचे, जिसको हम पाया कहते हैं आज की तारीख में, फाउंडेशन स्टोन कहते हैं, पंचशिला स्थापन है, वो वहाँ तक पहुँच जाए जहाँ तक नमी मिले। धरती के ऊपर से खोदते हुए वो कूर्मशिला वहाँ तक पहुँचे जहाँ पानी तो ना मिले पर पानी से ऊपर का लेवल करीबन 1 मीटर से 2 मीटर के बीच में, जब जमीन में नमी हो। द टोटल आउटकम ऑफ दिस कंसेप्ट वॉज टू ब्रिंग जियोथर्मल एनर्जी एंड ऑल द इक्विलिब्रियम फोर्सेस डाउन द अर्थ फ्रॉम द कूर्मशिला टू द ग्राउंड फ्लोर लेवल ऑफ द हाउस। तो मेरी रिक्वेस्ट है कि वास्तु पुरुष को इस ढंग से एक्सप्लेन करते हुए हम वास्तुशास्त्र को आईकास के माध्यम से बिल्कुल साइंटिफिक मोड में ले जाएं। मैंने 3 शब्द इस्तेमाल किए हैं, जहां हमारा जन्म हुआ, वेयर वी टुक बर्थ, इज द इक्विलिब्रियम पॉइंट ऑफ सेंट्रिपिटल एंड सेंट्रिफ्यूगल फोर्सेस ऑन अर्थ। ये आकाश और पाताल का भी संतुलनकारी बिंदु है। आप कल्पना करें अर्धरात्रि को जब हम सूर्य से उल्टी दिशा में पृथ्वी पर हों, जब सूर्य चतुर्थ भाव में हों, उस समय हम समझ रहे हैं कि हम पृथ्वी पर खड़े हैं, चल रहे हैं, कार चला रहे हैं, जबकि वास्तविकता यह है कि हम पृथ्वी पर अर्धरात्रि में सूर्य से उल्टी दिशा में उल्टे लटक रहे होते हैं। अगर सेंट्रिपेटल और सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्सेस का इक्विलिब्रियम पॉइंट अर्थ के उस बिंदु पर नहीं हो जहाँ कि हम हैं, अगर सूर्य और पृथ्वी के बीच का आकर्षण बल समाप्त हो जाए तो हम एक रॉकेट की तरह अनंत गति से अनंत आसमान में विलीन हो जाएंगे। हम सदा इस भ्रम पर जीते हैं कि हम पृथ्वी पर चल रहे हैं, हम पृथ्वी पर खड़े हैं। हकीकत यह है कि हम सिर के बल पृथ्वी पर अर्धरात्रि में उल्टे लटक रहे हैं। तो वास्तु पुरुष के कंसेप्ट के पीछे बहुत सारी वैज्ञानिक धारणाएं जुड़ी हैं, हम लोगों को समझना चाहिए। आज हम विद्यार्थी हैं, कल हम टीचर होंगे, परसों हम गुरु बनेंगे और अनंत भारत में धर्म भीरु भारतीय जनता को समझाने के दृष्टिकोण से पहले हमको विज्ञान समृद्ध होना होगा, उसके बाद हम लोगों को पढ़ाने की योग्यता रखेंगे। मैं आईकास में इतने अच्छे ओरेटर्स हैं, कुछ उनको जनता सुनना चाहती है, समझना चाहती है। हम अगर अपनी विद्वत्ता को प्रदर्शित करेंगे तो जनता को नहीं समझा पाएंगे। इस देश की दुनिया की सबसे महान संस्था के प्रतिनिधि होने के नाते हम उन इस शास्त्रों के इस वैज्ञानिक स्वरूप को सरल शब्दों में जनता तक पहुंचाएं, इसके पहले हमको शास्त्रों का गहन अध्ययन कर लेना चाहिए। इसीलिए शास्त्रों में कूर्म पृष्ठ वास्तुशास्त्र की भूमि में रचना की तारीफ की गई है। कूर्म पृष्ठ का अर्थ यह है, न गज पृष्ठ न दैत्य पृष्ठ, उसको मैं आगे चलकर बताऊंगा, परंतु ऐसा भूखंड जो चारों दिशाओं में समान रूप से ढलान वाला हो, तब कछुए की पीठ जैसा बनेगा। इट शुड लुक लाइक ए टॉर्टोइस एग्जैक्टली स्लोपिंग इक्वली ऑन ऑल द साइड्स, देन इट्स ऑस्पिशियस, अदर इज नॉट, अदरवाइज इज नॉट ऑस्पिशियस। कमिंग टू बिफोर दिस स्लाइड, मैं एक बात और कहना चाहता हूं कि वास्तु पुरुष का कंसेप्ट, वास्तु पुरुष को वास्तु शास्त्र का संविधान मानकर चलें। वास्तु पुरुष एक दैवीय रचना है, भगवान शंकर के पसीने से उत्पन्न, बहुत तीव्र गति थी। जब जितने भी लोग ऐसे, चाहे घटोत्कच हो भीम का पुत्र और चाहे वास्तु पुरुष हो, ऐसे बहुत सारे अवतारों ने जन्म लिया जो आकस्मिक रूप से उत्पन्न हुए, पर उनकी उस गति को, हेलो स्क्रीन शेयर करता हूं, इस स्लाइड पर आने से पहले मैं वास्तु पुरुष की बात करूंगा। जो संविधान है वास्तुशास्त्र का, कि वो बहुत तेज गति से धरती पर जन्म लिया, टाइम एंड स्पेस जो फोर्थ डायमेंशन से ऊपर का डायमेंशन है, उस गति से आए पृथ्वी पर अवतरण के लिए उनके स्पीड को नियंत्रित करना जरूरी हो गया था, इसलिए देवताओं की आवश्यकता पड़ी। ऐसी कोई ताकत नहीं थी जो वास्तु पुरुष, जो कि पहले राक्षस था बाद में ब्रह्मा के वरदान से देवता हो गए, कि उनकी स्पीड को नियंत्रित करना पड़ा। वो इतने शक्तिशाली थे और पता नहीं कौन सी डायमेंशन, हम तो थ्री डायमेंशनल वर्ल्ड में रहते हैं, परंतु वो किसी बहुत ऊंची डायमेंशन से आए थे, उनकी स्पीड को नियंत्रित करने के लिए इतने सारे देवताओं को लगना पड़ा। हम लोग एक भ्रम में जी रहे हैं कि वास्तु चक्र में 45 देवता होते हैं। वी आर इन ए ग्रेट इल्यूजन दैट देयर आर ओनली 45 डीटीज इन ए वास्तु चक्र। देयर आर सम ग्रुप डीटीज एंड आई डोंट नो व्हाई, बट दे हैव बीन अवॉर्डेड ए सिंगल स्क्वायर इन ए वास्तु चक्र ऑफ द मोस्ट पॉपुलर वास्तु चक्र ऑफ 81 स्क्वायर्स। For example, Dwadas Aditya, they have been given more squares, but when we talk of Rudra, so they are 11 in number, but given a single square. Vasuki, they are 8 in number, but they have been collectively given a single square. In the south direction, there is a square allotted to Gandharva. He is not a single deity. All Gandharvas, Apsaras, Vidyadhar, all are sharing the same square. The sanctity of this square or the importance of this square can only be seen while practicing Vastu in the field. When I wanted to develop some persons in the line of Gandharva Vidyas, as you know, Arjuna gave Gandharva Vidya in the court of King Virat, and the girl who later became the daughter-in-law of Arjun, the wife of Abhimanyu, Uttara. So this is square, this Vastupad can give hundreds of arts attributed to different categories of deities. Generally, it's not 45 deities. If we count them, they may exceed total number of 91. It may be more than 91. So far, I could identify 91 deities in a Vastu Chakra. This is a new thing for the newcomers. Our old persons doing research in the Vastu may know it, but the new persons only know, they know that only 45 deities are there. Please forget this. Count the group deities also who have been given, awarded single squares or two squares. On the other hand, you may find Indra in two places. So this is not the time that I can explain these things in details, but some controversies which are prevailing, I'm finding them, bringing them out for more researches. And I should now shift to Vishwakarma. Yesterday only we had a yagya for Vishwakarma in my office with all my disciples. Vastupurush is a constitution. Well, Vishwakarma is an executive agency complying with the rules of Vastupurush on a plot of land. It may be palace, it may be house, it may be township, it may be even a smallest particle of the world. Since Vastupurush is omnipresent, he's like Atma. For example, an Atma should have a territorial jurisdiction, a defined body. If we don't have a defined body, Atma cannot find a place in a living being. Likewise, in a plot of land, Vastupurush shrinks himself up to the size of the plot of land. If you subdivide the plot in so many parts, along with legal transfers, you will find that the Vastupurush has taken birth in all the small plots, so defined. But the subdivision should not be irrevocable. It should be last and final. Then the Vastupurush assumes the shape and size of the smallest part, the smallest plot of land. You can imagine, on the same analogy, that a girl giving birth to a child, the moment child is separated, a separate Atma is incarnated in the newly born baby. Same is the Vastupurush. If you sell a part of a plot of land, a different Vastupurush is born. So, Vishwakarma has no connection with this deity part, spiritual part, mythological part of Vastupurush, but an executing agency in charge of the constructions on land, and that's why the modern architects can be deemed to be the representatives of our Vishwakarma. Naturally, it's a deity. It's a super deity. Why? Daughter of Vishwakarma is married to son, the Vivaswan, the southern part of the Vastu Chakra, right south of the Brahmasthan. The Vishwakarma is given credit of reshaping the sun because his wife Sangya was not able to afford his energy and aggrieved from that violent part of sun. She left sun for some time, handing over charge टू द संध्या ए डिफरेंट डिफरेंट से इनकार्नेशन ऑफ संज्ञा द फर्स्ट वाइफ ऑफ सूर्य एनी वे सो विश्वकर्मा इज ऑल्सो नॉट लेस देन वास्तुपुरुष बट ही इज नॉट सपोज टू वायलेट द रूल्स फ्रेम इन फेवर ऑफ वास्तुपुरुष ही इज ऑलवेज सबॉर्डिनेट टू वास्तुपुरुष बट ही हैज बीन गिवन ए बून बाय द ब्रह्मा दैट without any fear, without any rajbhay, he will add an advice to the then king Prithu and now owner of the plot of land. So town planning departments are subject matter of Vishwakarma. While Delhi Development Authority, Jaipur Development Authority like institutions are part of Vastupurush. Now I shift to importance of longitude and latitude in a Vastu Chakra. From the God-fearing general public, the ancient sages given these lines on a Vastu Chakra, the name of deities, 10 deities vertical, 10 deities horizontal, 10 by 10 frame the 81 squares in a most popular parabshaik form of Vastu Chakra. What is the scientific logic behind this Vastu Chakra and these deities? It's line of longitude and line of latitudes. The energy currents, the electromagnetic influence from north to south on Earth is presumed or deemed to flow in the form of a parallel lines from north to south, and anything which is in synchronization of these lines can only be successful on Earth. The ancient sages did a great research on this topic, and I am happy to say that the best experimentation was done on the land where I am living today, the pink city of Jaipur. The Jaipur kings followed the latitudes and longitudes on Earth and developed a new city of Jaipur, because the king Jai Singh knew the astronomy. He constructed 5 observatories in India. Amongst them, Jaipur is live and still working on the Vedas of the nakshatras and planets and helping Panchang doing persons. But the Chittorgarh or Udaipur kings did not know so much astronomy. They did not have relations with Faras, Iran, Iraq, Yunnan for importing such researches on astronomy from there to India. The result is very clear. The Jaipur, who should have developed in 3,000 years, is developed within next 300 of its foundation. In my today practice, I always see any house, the walls of the house, if are not parallel to the line of latitudes and line of longitudes, is not so much successful as compared to that house whose walls are constructed parallel to the line of latitudes and line of longitudes. That much I want to say. For before shifting to another side, I will also mention a single point. Apart from this, this is not sufficient. We need to work out on the secret vital points of Vastupurush apart from erecting walls parallel to the line of longitude and line of latitude, plus the secret points of Vastupur, for which I am coming to my next slide. I think this part of the brain is visible to everyone. Just wait. We know some varmasthana are defined within the brain portion of the Vastupurush. Some varmasthana are placed in brahmasthana, 5 within brahmasthana and 4 outside brahmasthana. Brahmasthana is told by general people a central point of the plot of land. It's not so. In some matters, the area defined to Brahmasthan may differ. In 64 square plan, it has a different ratio. In 81 square plan, it's a different ratio, Brahma. Being the mightiest, but sometimes you have been given less space in a Vastu Chakra. In a 100 square Vastu plan, Brahma may have different ratio. So there is a question before everyone. Is in different Vastu plans, Marmisthans, the place of Marmisthan is changed? I'll not speak now on this because it's a very important question. We'll discuss it later on, just on this point, not now. But you may see the question of Shana Mahanti. The term explained in Samarangana Sutradhar, Shana Mahanti. 6 major Marmisthans are situated from the head of the Vastupurush up to the navel portion of the Vastupurush and little down. But when we go into the deeper side of the text, we know that these are not only 9 or 6 Marmisthanas, but the number of Marmisthanas are very much. For calculation of Marmisthanas, we need to know, as told in the Narada Samhita, the Pishach Sthan, which is shown in the color portion of this chakra, and Pishach Shishu, that you may find from the central place up to the Shikhi, the northeast part of Vastu Chakra. My request is, please find more Marmisthanas, which are not less than 70 in number in a Vastu Purush. Main jo baat janta hun, कि एक भी मर्म स्थान से एक भी दीवार बन गई तो 1,000 रुपया 1 रुपये में बदल जाएगा। अगर हम मर्म स्थानों पर दीवारों को जाने से रोक दें या कॉलम्स को नहीं बनने दें, जो कॉलम या खंभे 1x1 फुट के दिखते हैं मकान में ऊपर से, वो जमीन के नीचे 6x6 फुट के फाउंडेशन पर आधारित होते हैं, जो कि जमीन के नीचे वास्तु पुरुष से छेड़छाड़ करते हैं। फाउंडेशंस ऑफ कॉलम स्ट्रक्चर्स आर फाउंड इन मोस्ट केसेस वायलेटिंग मर्मस्थान ऑफ द वास्तु पुरुष। दोज हु डू नॉट नो द साइज ऑफ द फाउंडेशंस इन ए हाउस cannot do a good vastu. You please don't go just taking a compass in the hand, enter the house and start speaking about the vastu of the house. Forget this practice, please. You please get the AutoCAD drawing of the house first, then detect the measurements of the foundations of the columns and the walls. The wall which is 1 foot above the ground level is 3 feet wide down the earth. That may be found violating Vastu Purush, Marmistan of the Vastu Purush. So my request is, all Karmakandis Pandits who do not have even a compass and a representative of ICAS, before going to the plot of land, should demand AutoCAD drawing of the plot of land or the house already constructed, and also demand, please, measurements of the foundations of the columns and walls. How much this is important to display this, I'm going to next slide. This one. This is carotid artery. This is carotid artery bringing blood to the brain. Any cut from small to big, it may be a small cat, it may be a tiger, always have a tendency to attack on this carotid artery. You see a tiger attacking on even an elephant, attacks here. It takes a strong grip of carotid artery in his mouth, and the creature collapses within a minute's time. He has a stronghold, and in spite of several minutes fight between the two creatures, who wins? Who has a stronghold on this carotid artery? This is the marmasthan of the every creature. Surprisingly, the most vital marmasthan of the Vastu Purush is hair. Hair is the Pishach Shishu, as described in Narada Samhita. Hair is the Shan Mahanti. Hair is the strongest marmasthan of the Vastu Purush. So ancient sages first studied the anatomy of the human beings, then equated them with the newly born Vastu Purush, found the similarities, as we also found similarities between the Rashis and Nakshatras, and given them shapes and size of the animals and creatures. On the same analogy, they studied very well the marmasthan of a body, and then came down to the Shastras, given rules. But Ayurvedacharya were more intelligent. Charak and Sushrut have defined, researched 108 marmasthan in a body. You know, hundreds of years ago, when one used to go to the ashram for study, he had to learn Veda, Vedangas, Samhitas, Upanishads all together. One who was Ayurvedacharya was essentially an astrologer. One who was an astrologer was essentially an Ayurvedacharya also. They took help of each other. Now the two Vedangas are taught different in different universities, colleges, and we forgot the old traditions. But I'm sure we should connect these sciences together, and ICAS must take a lead in finding it out. I am requesting Sri A.B. Shuklaji kindly arrange for a research countrywide in ICAS chapters to identify 108 marmasthan in a Vastu Chakra. You will find, I have identified, I am writing on this. But this should not be a question of a single man research. For the welfare of the human man, we should interpolate all these in 108 marmasthan of Ayurveda in a Vastu Chakra. Now, everyone knows only 9 Vastu Chakra or Shan Mahanti, and that's all. I'm not satisfied with this. But when I did field practice in these areas and saved all other Marmistans also who are not defined in the text, I got a wonderful result. Sometimes in the increase of turnovers by 15 to 20,000 of crores. I'll name some companies, not now. It's not a marketing point. But I can give a note on this to our Honorable President for my work. Now, I connect this Vastu Shastra to the Sapta Nadi or Shat Nadi Chakra. See, I have superimposed Shat Nadi or Sapta Nadi on a Vastu Chakra. Starting from the Shikhi part of the Vastu Purush, Sahasrara Chakra, then Agya Chakra, and the downmost is the Muladhar Chakra, their characteristics. We should know that Jupiter and Saturn fall in the middle of this and can be equated to the second brain, as the modern scientists are inventing that there must be a second brain in the body. The logic behind this is that some actions are taken by the body without the help of the brain. Anechik kriya. Some voluntary actions by the blood body organs are done without the help of the brain. They get a stimulus right from the center of the body. The Jeev Chakra, the Anahat Chakra, the Vishuddha Chakra, air and space are very, very important. Apart from Manipur Chakra, which is fire, third from the tail. Why not we connect the strongest Marmasthan from the Shat Chakra theory? A few years ago, someone came from America, got a scan of my palm and shown a picture on his screen in which all the chakras were displayed in the very colored form. To my dismay, it was very surprising that the strongest planet in my horoscope was illuminating very much on that screen. It was a mechanical work. My palm was a screen, and the Shat Chakra was on my computer, and the exalted planet was showing maximum luminous on the screen, and the weakest planet was less illuminating on that Shat Chakra. What was the conclusion? Did the ancient sages knew the placement of chakras? It was how surprising that while calculating my aura, the aura of that planet was mechanically shown on a screen very much, which belonged to the strongest planet. This is a matter of research, and we can work out additionally, in addition to the ancient Vastu rules given in our books. Now, I come to some part of astrology explaining Vastu Chakra. For example, there is one point of research is also there, which can be done. I brought some such things which we should work collectively. ये तीन द्वार उत्तर दिशा में सर्वश्रेष्ठ बताए गए हैं, परंतु पूर्व और पश्चिम में केवल दो द्वार अच्छे बताए गए हैं। उनकी संख्या दक्षिण में एक ही हो रह गई है। यद्यपि ये वितत नहीं, गृहक्षत है ये। सॉरी, ये ब्लू इज वितत, व्हाइल द ऑस्पिशियस गेट इज गृहक्षत, not with us. क्या लॉजिक हो सकती है इसकी? ऋषियों ने इस पर काम किया और एक चीज को आप एक तथ्य को इससे कनेक्ट कर सकते हैं कि अयनांश जो थ्योरी है उसको वास्तु चक्र पर लागू करने की कोशिश की गई है। हम जानते हैं कि हमारा अधिकतम अयनांश 24 डिग्री है, थोड़ा सा बढ़ेगा फिर वापस आ जाएगा। सन इज ऑसिलेटिंग इन इट्स ऑर्बिट सम टाइम इयर्स बैक, इट वॉज इन द कॉर्डिनल ईस्ट वेस्ट डायरेक्शन, नाउ शिफ्टिंग टुवर्ड्स नॉर्थ ईस्ट एट द रेट ऑफ 50 सही 1/3 विकला पर ईयर, एंड नाउ इट हैज रीच टू 24 डिग्रीज इन ऑल। ये दिखेगा आप सोम के बीचों बीच से एक ब्रह्मिस्थान से रेखा लेके सोम के बीचों बीच तक ले जाइए, सोम का 5 डिग्री चरक की तरफ रह जाएगा, 5 डिग्री भल्लाट की तरफ रह जाएगा। दस ग्यारह डिग्री भल्लाट का और 10-11 डिग्री मुख्य का। जितना मैक्सिमम अयनांश हो सकता है उतनी ही द्वार योजना दी गई है। केवल प्रेडिक्टिव पार्ट ऑफ वास्तु में ईस्ट और वेस्ट में 3 पद इस्तेमाल नहीं किए गए हैं। ऐसा नहीं है पूर्व दिशा में इंद्र और जयंत ही शुभ हैं, हम लोग ऐसा मानते हैं, शास्त्रों में ऐसा वर्णन है, परंतु पूर्व और पश्चिम दिशा में भी एक एक द्वार और बढ़ाया जा सकता था, ऐसा नहीं बढ़ाया गया। कंट्रडिक्शन क्या है? इफ वी फॉलो the Ainan system on a Vastu Chakra, we may find 3 gates, 3 squares auspices in the north direction, but this has not been worked out in the south direction. If this theory is true, then there must be at least 3 gates auspices in the south direction also, and 3 gate on east and west directions. ऐसा क्यों हो सकता है? हम एक कल्पना करें, कभी जब राहु की महादशा आती थी या अंतरदशा आती थी तो ऋषि लोग कहते थे कि अब राजा का पतन हो जाएगा, वो राहु दशा को शुभ नहीं मानते थे। क्यों? कि पुरुषार्थ चतुष्टय के जो चौथा पुरुषार्थ है मोक्ष, उसके काम में राहु बाधक है। क्यों बाधक है? कि राहु के कारण से चारों पुरुषार्थ में से अर्थ और काम का नियंत्रण अगर धर्म से हो इफ अर्थ एंड काम आर स्ट्रिक्ट कंट्रोल ऑफ धर्म देन ओनली लिबरेशन और मोक्ष कैन बी अचीव्ड, एंड धर्म इज अपोज टू राहु, राहु इज अपोज टू धर्म। अगर पुराना राजा 500 साल पहले का राहु महादशा में आया तो ऋषि लोग कहते थे इसका पतन हो गया। ऋषि लौकिक समृद्धि से पतन नहीं मानते थे, वो राजा अनाचार करेगा, गलतियां करेगा, प्रजा को दुख देगा और उसका मोक्ष नहीं होगा, इसलिए पतन मान लिया उन्होंने। पर आज के जितने भी राजा बने हैं वो राहु के प्रभाव में ही बने हैं, एंड दिस वाज अपोज टू द थ्योरी ऑफ द एंशिएंट सेजेस। माय वर्जन इज फॉर अचीविंग सच ए ग्रेट किंगडम लाइक इंडिया, क्वालिटीज ऑफ दीज यम गृहक्षत एंड वितथ ऑल should be there in the persons leading in today's politics. So if a line is drawn from the center of the Vastu Chakra to the cardinal north and to the cardinal south, उस लाइन को हम शिफ्ट करें आयनांस की अधिकतम सीमा तक, मुख्य तक, उतना ही एंगल यम से, साउथ में यम से साउथ ईस्ट की तरफ जाना चाहिए और उन गेट्स को आज की तारीख में ऑस्पिशियस माना जाना चाहिए, क्योंकि आज के राजा या अधिकारी और उनको ये इतना बड़ा राज्य प्राप्त करने के लिए ये सब चीज़ें चाहिए। मेरी आईकास से रिक्वेस्ट है कि इस विषय पर स्टेटिस्टिकल एग्जामिनेशन करा के और रिसर्च को मोटिवेट करना चाहिए। मुझसे जितना आता है मैं सेवा में हाजिर हूँ। ए बी शुक्ला ये कार्य कर सकते हैं, आज तक के जो प्रेसिडेंट्स में बहुत सबसे ज़्यादा इनोवेटिव शुक्ला जी निकले हैं। मैं कामना करता हूँ इस बात पर भी विचार आगे किया जाएगा। अब मैं दैत्य पृष्ठ, गज पृष्ठ और नाग पृष्ठ स्ट्रक्चर्स पर आता हूं। पुरानी कहावत है, दक्षिण भारी उत्तर हल्का, पश्चिम भारी पूर्व हल्का। लेस कंस्ट्रक्शन इन ईस्ट, मोर कंस्ट्रक्शन इन वेस्ट, एंड लेस कंस्ट्रक्शन और एम्प्टी लैंड इन नॉर्थ एंड मैक्सिमम कंस्ट्रक्शन इन साउथ डायरेक्शन, दैट इज गज पृष्ठ। This slide is showing total construction in the north direction. उत्तर दिशा में आप केवल उत्तर दिशा में मकान बना लीजिए, उस घर में लक्ष्मी और पुत्र नहीं आएगा। मैंने जिन इंडस्ट्रीज में शेड्स को केवल नॉर्थ डायरेक्शन में बना हुआ देखा है, जिनमें जयपुर की एक बहुत बड़ी पौधदार मिल शामिल है, उनमें हड़ताल, तालाबंदी एंड अल्टीमेटली क्लोजर ऑफ द फैक्ट्री दिखती है। और सरप्राइजिंगली है कि उत्तर दिशा से अगर मैग्नेटिक इन्फ्लुएंसेस का मकान में आना रोक दिया जाए तो उस घर में लड़का जन्म नहीं लेता। आई हैव टेस्टेड इट सेवरल टाइम्स। दो पॉइंट ऐसे हैं कि अगर परजन्य का द्वार हो तो लड़के लड़कियां होती हैं। मैंने इसका फील्ड में टेस्टिंग भी किया है, क्यों है, क्या है, अलग कारण हो सकता है। परजन्य देवता किसी और चीज के हैं, पर लड़कियां वहां से आती हैं। पर जिनके लड़कियां पहले से हो उस घर की लड़कियां बहुत गुणी हो जाती हैं। जो लोग स्त्रियों का सुख बढ़ाना चाहते हैं उनको परजन्य का द्वार करना ही चाहिए, परंतु उत्तर दिशा का कंस्ट्रक्शन स्त्री पुरुष दोनों पर समान रूप से लागू होता है। अब मैं दूसरी स्लाइड बताऊंगा। हाँ, एक बात कह देता हूं मैं कि अगर किसी का टोटल विनाश करना हो तो नॉर्थ ईस्ट या ईस्ट में स्ट्रक्चर कर दीजिए, वो भूखंड कभी भी डेवलप नहीं होगा। ये देखिए, इसमें नॉर्थ और नॉर्थ ईस्ट में निर्माण हुआ पड़ा है। फिर चाहे कितनी ही बड़ी जनपत्रिका हो, कितनी अच्छी जनपत्रिका हो और कितना ही सुंदर मकान हो, इस मकान वाले का पतन होना बहुत जरूरी है। मकान बनने के तीसरे चौथे साल से रिजल्ट आना शुरू हो जाता है। ये देखिए, नॉर्थ सबसे ऊंचा और साउथ सबसे नीचा। ये मकान मालिक, ये इंडस्ट्री कभी भी नहीं पनप सकती। उसने मकान यहां बनाया, अमेरिका जाके बस गया, पर ये मकान उसका पीछा नहीं छोड़ेगा। संसार में कहीं चला जाए उसकी खरीद शुद्धा संपत्ति उसको असर देती रहेगी। ये गजपृष्ठ का उदाहरण है, जब टोटल कंस्ट्रक्शन साउथ डायरेक्शन में। अब किसी वास्तु पुरुष का निर्माण मत करिए, किसी मकान का निर्माण मत करिए, आप कहीं भी कोई निर्माण मत करिए, आप किसी भी नियम का पालन मत करिए, पर ये जो दिख रहा है ऐसा कर लीजिए। फिर चाहे गेट गलत हो चाहे कुछ हो, आदमी की उन्नति जरूरी है। If you construct a house in the Vivasvan area of a Vastu Chakra, that is sharp south of the Brahmistan, the person is bound to go high. High in business, high in reputation, and also in commanding position in the state, in the nation. So this is a very good example of Gaj Prashn. But for more influence, you should construct in west direction also. If you go this way, the revenue, the regular revenue, the regular income from different sources is bound to come. When South gives you a good command over everyone, West is supposed to give you revenue from every side and best professionals. If you want a good obedience from the subordinates, you should give them place in the west direction. As I already mentioned, in Bangalore, there's not a single example of master bedroom in southwest direction. It was a shastragar in ancient texts. But we are suggesting machines in the southwest direction in today's industries, but not the master bedroom. It's eighth house. It's eighth house bringing bad habits also along with the big money. So ultimately this causes a downfall of the family. This is a house where west and south is highest elevated. A gate in the Mukhi and Bhallad direction and a gate in the west direction of Varun gives plenty of money and command. You can do your elevation in a way that the south and west directions becomes highest part of the building right before the black stone in the southwest direction is a lift portion which is elevated. This is lift portion in order to give height to the south direction, south and west. Now I am shifting to Dakshin mein unchi, Uttar mein unchi aur beech mein khadda, dhalan, slope, madhya plava, madhya mein plav, jaisa saamp ka hota hai. It's a snake structure. A land elevated in all the directions but sloped in the middle. What is the qualities of a snake? Biting, back biting. Astin ka saap. Enemies everywhere. So these types of houses are bad. You should prefer a Gaj Prashn structure. Maybe as an exception, a Kurm Prashn structure, the posterior of which looks like a tortoise, a land elevated in the middle and sloping equally on all the sides. Kurm Prashn is also appreciated in the ancient texts. Now I am coming to an important point. This is a 30-60 size. 30 in the east and 60 in the north. A Karmkandi Pandit came to the house and laid the foundation stone, presuming this to be the northeast direction. He does not know compass. He also forgot then the Nakshatra Ved system from his guru. I learned this from my guru. But today I don't find any single person who are doing Nakshatra Ved or any such practice which will lead to a measurement of good directions. Now compass is everywhere available. A digital compass is not so good as the manual compass is, because apart from north directions, cardinal north, magnetic declination has to be taken into consideration. The magnetic north, the electromagnetic currents of north to south are shifting from north to northwest direction at the rate of 15 meters per annum. It is presumed that after 5 lakh years, north will be south and south will be north. Or magnet द मैग्नेट ऑफ द अर्थ विल टोटली बी रिवर्स्ड. सो मैनुअल कंपासेस आर ऑलवेज बेटर बिकॉज दे शो द ट्रू मैग्नेटिक इन्फ्लुएंस ऑन अर्थ, इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक करंट फ्लोइंग फ्रॉम नॉर्थ टू साउथ डायरेक्शन. ऑल्सो इज देर एनी जियोपैथिक स्ट्रेस, एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ वायलेशन डाउन द अर्थ ड्यू टू द मिनरल्स एंड मेटल्स. इफ मैग्नेटिज्म ऑफ द लोकल एरिया इज चेंज, द हैंडी कंपास इज ऑलवेज हेल्पफुल इन करेक्ट मेजरमेंट्स ऑफ द डायरेक्शन ऑन ए प्लॉट ऑफ लैंड. आई गॉन टू द हाउस वेयर वेयर फाउंडेशन वॉज लेड इन द नॉर्थ ईस्ट डायरेक्शन. वेन आई अप्लाइड माई कंपास देयर, द नॉर्थ ईस्ट वॉज फाउंड at a different place. You all know that Vastu Purush is defined, is placed in a square structure only. All those plots of land or houses which are not square are defective somehow to the extent there is a difference in their length and width of the plot of land. So northeast is not this where the pandit laid down the stone. Actual northeast is this. Why this happen? You will always found if fourth house of the house is afflicted by Rahu in any form, the placement of Paya is always wrong. What will happen now? The laying of foundation stone is almost a prana pratishtha of the foundation stone. You cannot change it. And the Kurma Prashta, Kurma Shala Sthapan theory is based on the Kurma Avatar of the Vishnu, that any structure will be found quite stable for hundreds of years long if the Kurma Shala Sthapan is done in the correct direction and the correct way. But such faults are very often these days. The Pandit laid down in the so-called northeast direction. When a Vastu person gone to the plot of land, then now the northeast was found at a different place. What to do now? You cannot cut it down now. You cannot remove this place. As a result, the man is bound to get bad results throughout the life. Now I am for a couple of minutes. Something which may be new to our learners. Suppose you are with a very good horoscope and two good planets are placed in the third house of your horoscope. Your third house is northeast. Seventh house to your third house is your house of luck, house of fortune, that is your ninth house. If you have good planets in third house, your southwest, south center to southwest must be very good from the Vastu point of view. Vice versa, if you have a bad planet, malefics in the third house, like Saturn and Mars, aspecting your north house, ninth house, this will mean that you have a bad Vastu in the southwest direction of the house. Take another example. If you have good planets in the fourth house, that is house of land, plots, properties, vehicles, Sukh. If you have a good fortification of your fourth house, your properties increases. If you have a Lagnesh having relation with the fourth house, you may purchase properties in various cities. If you have relation of your Mercury with the fourth house, it will be very good exterior of your house using the stones,
शिल्प शास्त्र प्रवर्तका। बुध क्या है? शिल्प शास्त्र प्रवर्तका। शिल्प तब है जब पत्थर का प्रयोग हो। सी हेयर, फोर्थ हाउस लॉर्ड इज रेट्रोग्रेड एंड प्लेस्ड इन द नॉर्थ ईस्ट डायरेक्शन। एंड मून इज नॉट वेरी मच हैप्पी विद बींग प्लेस्ड इन द कंजंक्शन और वेरी क्लोज टू द सैटर्न, इज नॉट गुड। सो इन स्पाइट ऑफ मून एस्पेक्टिंग हिज ओन हाउस इन नाइन्थ हाउस, सैटर्न एंड केतु आर एफ्लिक्टिंग योर नाइन्थ हाउस। ए वास्तु रिजल्ट इज विद यू कैन सी इट विदाउट गोइंग टू द प्लॉट ऑफ लैंड that his southwest is afflicted badly. And in every case, if Rahu is afflicting your fourth house, it's a bad vastu case. Jupiter aspecting fourth house means you will not lose properties in the current generation. You will leave something for your next generations. But if Rahu is affecting anyway your fourth house, fourth lord, then you are bound to sell your properties for any reason. And your next generation will strive for ancestral properties from your side. So if fourth house is well fortified, go to the seventh house, go to the tenth house. That is south of your house, south direction of your house. If good planets in fourth house, very good vastu construction in south side. If very good planets are in tenth house, you may have a very good vastu structure in north side, that is your fourth house, Patal. On the same analogy, if you have very good or auspicious planets in your Lagna, your west must be found more profound, good structures and much money giving. This also mean astrologically that if seventh house has good aspects, you will develop associations, partnerships with more people, will be more popular, and fourth house also may help you. So this is all seeing astrological way for a good vastu. That Shubh Graha in any house gives a very good vastu in its seventh house direction. Pap Graha in any house may give a bad vastu in the seventh house from that house. So an astrological chart explains beautifully the concept of Gajaprastha and Daityaprastha theory. I'm not explaining here the Nagaprastha, which is often found when the most planets are in the clutches of Rahu and Ketu. A Nag is equated with the Rahu. Nag is equated with the Rahu. And if the planets are in the bad clutches of Rahu or surrounding Rahu or very close to the Rahu, the Nagaprastha structures are found. I have done a statistical work in these matters and preparing a research paper will be published in my next book. So here I am closing. I want to leave here with my lecture. And if there is any question, I am ready to answer it.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you for enlightening us on different aspect of Vastu Shastra. There are a few questions from the viewers. I will display on the screen. So that one question, request you to guide regarding three roads hitting to side at east, west, north, south, or north, east, southeast, northwest, southwest. Its effect on the life of the family members.
This is technically called Vithi Shul in the ancient text. Vithi means gully, street. and there is no exception in the old text about this. So all roads terminating on a house are supposed to be the bed. Which direction is afflicted, results will come from that side. Suppose west is hitting, your business is afflicted. If the road is terminating in the north of your house, then your family life will be disturbed. If east is hitting, your professional life will be disturbed. And if there is a termination of Vithi on south direction, your all relation will be destroyed. There is only exception to save from this bad point. That is, if there is any Rajpath surrounding the house, and then any road strikes on that Rajpath facing your house, then the result is diluted.
So, thank you, sir. Thank you very much. There is one more question.
Yeah.
What about floors? There are different Vastu Purush for different floors in a flat? I think the question is pertaining to a flat, seem to be.
Flats, so, yes.
Okay.
Your Vastu Purush is supposed to be an Atma in a body. Your Vastu Purush applies for that land only for which you have paid rent or money. Outside your flat area, there is a different Vastu Purush. So your Vastu Purush cannot claim a single square foot of other plot where second Vastu Purush is found. It's like two different physical bodies of human beings walking differently, sitting differently, but with different atmas. So flats also have Vastu Purushas independently. So you get result out of that flat only for which you have paid money or paying rent. Rental houses gives results in a later stage, not so early.
Thank you, sir. There is one question. Is the principle of higher south holds good in other part of the world, specifically in US?
Yes. I have tested the Vastu rules in so many countries also. The first experiment was done in Australia, where I got someone told me that a magnet is disturbed in the south direction. Number two, where the Vastu rules apply for India only or for abroad also. Because the old sages always used to say, Prithvi ka raj bhogo. So Prithvi means not the whole earth. They were blessing for the Aryavart only. It's not so. So Ravastu rules friend are of cosmopolitan nature, universal. In Australia, I found a gate right from the southeast to east direction, Antarikshpad. Chori deta, theft. So I declared that, is there any theft in your house? Well, yes, twice. He told me, my client. Then I asked him that on one occasion he was caught. He told me, yes. How do you know this? You know magic? Make no magic. This is simple calculation. Because the other gate was on Indra place from east to northeast, between north to east to northeast. Indra means kingly help. So all the government officers, ministers were helping that person. So thief came from the Antarikshpad into the house. There is always a theft if you have Antarikshpad. But the thief was caught second time because the royal persons helped the owner of the house. And by testing these two rules, it was confirmed in my mind that Vastu rules and directions are applicable worldwide. We can apply them anywhere. I tested these Vastu rules hundreds of times in entire Europe. I visited Europe more than I visited Delhi so far. So these rules holds good in not only in US, worldwide. But
thank you.
A magnetic compass must be in your hand, not the digital compass.
So So thank you, sir. There is one more question. Where should be the ideal location for a septic tank? Kindly enlighten.
Septic tank have two meanings. One, you destroy the sanctity of the deity system of the plot of land. So any deity will be annoyed of you if you dig a septic tank in a wrong direction. So cleverly, I always advise to have a septic tank outside the house boundaries, between the outer boundary and the road. And since this involves a question of depth also, there must be no depth in every direction. So apart from north to north direction, leave just a 10 degrees space from north to north direction, and septic tank can be there.
Thank you, sir.
It should not go towards northwest direction. Just leave cardinal north direction 5 degrees off from central line of north direction. Then go to any septic tank. Or it may be between north to northeast also, saving northeast zone. From north to northwest direction, 22 and half degrees are the north jurisdiction, then northeast jurisdiction starts. We may dig a little in this direction, but better option is from going from north to northwest direction, 5 to 6 degrees off north direction.
So there is one more interesting question on the 15-storied building. If the people are staying in a 15-storied building or more stories, will it not affect by Vastu principle? That's the question.
As compared to the gravitational forces of Earth and Sun, because you are in caught hold of gravitational pull of Earth better than Sun on 4 hours, you may go to 50-story also. It is very minimal effect on any story. You can go up to the last boundaries of gravitational pull, you will not be affected. You are equally affected by Earth's gravitational pull up to the hundreds of stories. It does not make any difference, but directions will work together. Gravitational pull is at least up to 100 kilometers above Earth, so you are not affected anyway. But when you get influence from underground water tanks and other structures which are possible on ground only, it might affect your vastu. Because on upper floors, you don't get benefit of geothermal energy and other things.
There is one question on lift. The lift direction, it's on the lift direction because of the weight on the south. But how to dig it in the south? So that is the question.
For south, you should select an hydraulic lift and try that the digging of lift from the lowest floor should not be more than 5 feet. Most often the lift persons advise you to have a 5 foot depth, four and a half feet or 5 feet depth. To counter this depth in the south direction, you must have another construction of at least a room which can equalize the weight and height of the machine room of the lift. This problem is not come from the hydraulic lifts.
Okay, there is one question on the rise in the northeast side than other sides. Will it impact the income, sources of income? That's the question.
Everything. I found deaths also from northeast direction.
Okay. There is... thank you very much, sir. It's a really enlightening session. We have with us Sri A.V. Shuklaji, our Honorary National President of ICAS. So I request Shukla ji to speak a few words.
Well, Ola ji, regarding Sri Satish Sharma, Pandit Satish Sharma rather, what should I say and what should I not say? I'm perplexed. A person having immense depth in field of Vastu and in field of Jyotisha requires no words of praise from me, because you don't show lamp to sun. It's already there. The whole world knows it. So I will not say anything about that. I have taken whatever he said very seriously, and I can commit only on 2-3 parts what he has said. Number one, he says there should be research on the 108 Marm points. I totally agree on that, and some work I have already started, because there is one mantra, very interesting. It connects Vastu, Jyotish, the spiritual sciences, the physics, metaphysics, biology, tantra, all in one. It says, Saptam Injanti Ratham Ek Chakram. The full mantra goes further deep on these very lines only. So it says, firstly, you must identify the numbers which have been allotted to various points on a Vastu, on the human body, and similarly for tantras, and what the sequence they have suggested. It said you must start from east. So starting, that should be point number one. Two is the southeast. Three is Mars, south. Fourth goes to southwest, Rahu. And fifth to west side, Saturn. Sixth, moon. Then seventh goes to north, Mercury. And eighth, northeast, Jupiter. Then ninth, they say, go upwards. 10 downwards. And zero is the center, the Brahmasthana. Neither above nor below. Thereafter, they say, specific importance has to be given to number 1, 3, and 7. What rishis have wanted to say from that, I'm working on it. So right now, I will not say what will be the outcome out of this. But this month, coupled with 2-3 more mantras from Atharvaveda and Rigveda jointly, I think they shall give a deeper sense in Vastu as well as Jyotish. Similarly, other point which he raised, the chakras, grahas, and the nakshatra, they should be joined, and some research should be done on those. So I can only confirm I'm working on those, and I can see what I have found. Again, taking clue from Rigveda and Atharveda, they say specific importance should be given to Adra, Hast, Purvasar, Uttarabhad, and Shravan. These have got very, very special role to play in Vastu as well as in astrology. And so far Chakraja is concerned, it says categorically that nowadays there is a common misconception that it is a Muladhari Saturn, because they say 10, 11, then they say Jupiter, and then Venus, and then they give Mars, so on and so forth. It says no. The Muladhari is connected to Prithvi Tattva and Mercury. Swadhisthan to Jal Tattva and Venus. Manipur, Agni Tattva and Mars. Anahat, Vaitattva and Saturn. That's why it's a Kal and Mahakal. It is here. Kal and Mahakal. And then they say Vishuddhi Chakra is good to Jupiter. And then they say Agya Chakra, Sahasra and Eighth Chakra, the hidden chakra, not discussed. Because we are not supposed to discuss the Eighth Chakra unless a person reaches that level. For the normal students, normal teacher, the knowledge must be confined to seven chakras, from Muladhar to Sahasrar. Only once you understand this fully, then you are allowed to go to the eighth chakra, which is in between Agya Chakra and Sahasrar. The exact location, I'm not going to tell you. So beautiful point was that this Adra, that pertains to entire Anahat only. Where a Hast, surprisingly, it covers part of Manipur, part of Muladhar, and part of Anahat. So that way, the Hast Nakshatra has got a wider role to play. because it controls the entire body system. And that way, the entire system of the Vastu also. The health of the person, health of the Vastu, would be depending much on the Hast Nakshatra. This Purvasad is very, very special. It has got major impact on Manipur and minor impact on the Swadhisthan. So we have to, as he has rightly pointed out, the locations of the all the chakras on the your Vastu chakra as well as the human body, beautifully done. So now you see this Purvasad going to affect Manipur and Swadhisthan both. So depending on the placement of Purvasad in your chart, the person whose Vastu you are going to do, you can immediately find out whether the Marg chakra, Marg sthana is going to be get affected or not. Immediately you can get corrected. Last is Uttarabhadrapad. Very strange. It connects again Manipur and Anahat, part of it. You have seen the locations on Vastu chakras. You know the placement of Nakshatras in your horoscope, and immediately you can see what is going to be the impact on the your Marmisthan. So that way he has done beautiful work. I can only just respond to his query, his observation that some work is going on. And courtesy Atharved, we shall be in a position to go deeper into it. And hopefully soon I might be in a position to get a paper presented by somebody. There are about 155 students in the class. They are all listening. So I've asked to make them a group and compile the observations from these mantras, and then we can further discuss. But the lecture has been eye-opener. He has requested for research. He has requested everybody to open eyes, go deeper, as he has been doing. His observation of going to America and seeing the position, connecting Australia, observation shifting of the magnetic axis in 5 lakhs, what is north is going south, south is going north, is very important. That needs to be taken very seriously. Nowadays, I've seen even our own students, they go to site, open their mobile and start doing it. It's not correct. He has very rightly observed, take a manual compass with you. If you're serious about Vastu, take the manual compass. In case you just want wishy-washy work, take your fee and come back, which was never the intention of ICAS. ICAS believed the pure spiritual sciences, the research, the scientific approach. And that's why when I presented this title, Jyotish Bhanu, to Satish Sharma ji, I was honoring myself more than honoring him, because God gave me opportunity to give that title to him through my hands, which he rightly deserved. I can't say anything more than that. Thank you very much.